हेलो गाइस, वेलकम बैक टू द चैनल। सो टुडे आल्सो वी आर गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू आवर चैप्टर दैट इज लैपलास ट्रांसफॉर्म। इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव सीन वन ऑफ द वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ लैपलास ट्रांसफॉर्म दैट इज इफेक्ट ऑफ मल्टीप्लीकेशन बाय टी। बट इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल सी अनदर प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ लैपलास ट्रांसफॉर्म दैट इज इफेक्ट ऑफ डिविजन बाय टी। दैट मीन्स सपोज दे हैव आस्क्ड यू टू फाइंड आउट Laplace transform of f of t by t. Okay, so we have the formula integration s to infinity phi of s ds, where phi of s is nothing but Laplace transform of this f of t. See here, phi of s is Laplace transform of this f of t. Now we will see an example to get you an idea about how to apply the formula. So the given example is you have to find Laplace transform of 1 upon t into 1 minus cos a t. So this is in the form Laplace transform of f of t divided by t, where f of t is 1 minus cos a t. So apply the formula. So in the solution, the first step will be you have to find Laplace transform of f of t. And what is f of t? The function which is multiplied with 1 upon t. Here, the function which is multiplied with 1 upon t is this bracket. So, we will assume this bracket be f of t. So, in first step, you have to find phi of s, that is Laplace transform of f of t is 1 minus cos a t. Now, you know the formula of Laplace transform of 1. That is 1 upon s, and you also know Laplace transform of cos a t, that is s upon s square plus a square, and this is nothing but phi of s. Now the next step will be you have to find Laplace transform of 1 upon t into f of t, that is you have to apply the formula. So here we will write Laplace transform of 1 upon t into f of t, that is 1 minus cos a t, is equal to, according to the formula, integration s to infinity phi of s. And what is your phi of s? So we have found in first step, that is 1 upon s minus s upon s square plus a square. We have to integrate with respect to s. So let's integrate this bracket. So integration of 1 upon s, that is log x. So let's write integration of 1 upon s, that is log s minus. Here we have to make some changes. So let's multiply with 2 and also divide with 2. So this is in the form of integration of f of x upon f dash x, where f of x is a function and f dash x means this numerator is its derivative. So see this, derivative of s square is 2s. So we will apply this formula. Here this 1 minus 1 upon 2 is constant, so let's write minus 1 upon 2 and the rest of the part, that is f of x. And in the numerator, its derivative f dash x. So this will become log of f of x, means log of denominator. Your denominator is s square plus a square. So log of s square plus a square. And the rule of definite integration, that is you have to take the limits. So the next step will be you have to apply the limit, that is upper limit minus lower limit. But see, upper limit is infinity. So if you apply, it will become log infinity minus half into log infinity square. So we cannot define it because infinity should be in the denominator. So this will become 1 upon infinity, that is 0. So you have to make some changes and you have to take this s or s square in the denominator. So because of that, you will get 1 upon infinity and you will get the answer 0. So make some changes to bring this s and this s square in the denominator. For that, let's multiply and divide this log s by 2. So we will multiply with 2 and divide with 2. Now in the next step, we will take half 1 by 2. See there, here it is 1 by 2, here also 1 by 2. So if you take this half outside the bracket, the remaining part will be, see, here we will take minus half outside the bracket, then the remaining part will be log s square plus a square, and here 2 log s, and the sign is minus, so this plus will become minus 2 log s, and the limits will be s to infinity. Now we know that log s, so this is in the form of a log b, so the solution will be log b raised to a, means this a will go to the power of b, so this will become log s, so minus log s, and this 2 will become power of s, so log s square, and the limits will be s to infinity. Now we know the formula for log a minus log b, so log a minus log b is equal to log of a upon b, so this will become minus half, so log a minus log b will become log of a by b, so log of a, that is s square plus a square upon b, so b is s square, and the limits are s to infinity. Now let's split the numerator, so this will become minus 1 by 2, s square upon s square is 1, plus a square upon s square. Now see, as I said, we have brought this s square in the denominator. Now when we apply the limits, that is upper limits minus lower limit, so this will become minus 1 by 2 upper limit, so log 1 plus a square upon infinity square, means infinity, so as I said 1 upon infinity is equal to 0, so 1 plus 0 will become log 1, so the upper limit will be log 1, minus lower limit, for lower limit you have to put s in place of s, means you have to write this function as it is, so minus lower limit will become log 1 plus a square upon s square. Now for final answer we will write, we know that the value of log 1, that is 0, so this is 0, minus half into minus half will be plus half log, if we cross multiply this will become s square plus a square upon s square, so this is your final answer of the given example. So that's how we have to apply the property, that is this formula, to solve the given example. Now we will see a different example which is based on this property. So for that we will use this same numerical. So we will write this your answer here. That is your Laplace transform of this function is nothing but half log s square plus a square upon s square. Now we will see that example which is based on this property. So the example is evaluate integration 0 to infinity e raised to minus 2t into 1 upon t into 1 minus cos at dt. So see the difference between this example and this example. You can see that this part, that is this bracket, is similar to your previous example, that is Laplace transform of 1 upon t, 1 minus cos at. So if in your exam suppose this question comes, then you have to first find out Laplace transform of this bracket. Okay, first you have to neglect this part, that is integration 0 to infinity e raised to minus 2t. You have to neglect it. First concentrate on this bracket. So like previous numerical, you will use that step and you will find out the Laplace transform of this bracket. So the Laplace transform of this bracket we have written, we have found out in previous numerical, that is 1 by 2 log s square plus a square upon s square. Now after this step, that is Laplace transform of 1 upon t 1 minus cos at is equal to half log s square plus a square upon s square, you will continue this solution. So the next step will be the Laplace transform of any function according to the definition of Laplace transform is nothing but integration 0 to infinity e raised to minus st f of t. Okay, so this is nothing but your integration 0 to infinity e raised to minus st f of t. F of t means the whole bracket, that is 1 upon t 1 minus cos at dt. Okay, but in the given example they have asked you to find out Laplace integration of 0 to infinity e raised to minus 2t, but according to the definition here it is e raised to minus st. So to change this function into e raised to minus 2t, what you have to do, you have to just replace this s with 2. So for s is equal to 2, this function will become 0 to infinity e raised to minus st will become minus 2t 1 upon t 1 minus cos at dt is equal to. So if you put s is equal to 2 on this side, you have to also take s is equal to 2 here also. So this will become half log s square will become 2 square plus a square upon s square, that is 2 square. So this will be your final answer. So the extra step will be you have to use the definition of Laplace transform and you have to just replace the s with the s which is given in the example. So let's move to the next numerical. So the next example is you have to find Laplace transform of 1 upon t e raised to 2t sine cube t. So like previous numerical, first of all we have to find Laplace transform of f of t. And what is f of t? F of t means the function which is multiplied with 1 upon t. So here the function which is multiplied with 1 upon t is this bracket. So you have to find Laplace transform of this f of t. So we cannot directly have formula for this. So we will find Laplace transform of this function step by step. So first of all, we will find Laplace transform of sine cube t. So we also don't have any direct formula for sine cube t. So we will convert using this formula of trigonometry, that is sine cube t. We will write 1 by 4 Laplace transform of 3 sine t minus sine 3 t. So 1 by 4 Laplace transform of sine t. So using formula for Laplace transform of sine a t, this will become a. Here a is 1. So 1 upon a square plus a square. So s square plus a square, that is 1 square will be 1, minus sine 3t. Here a is 3. So according to this formula, 3 upon a square plus a square. So a square plus, as I said, a is 3. So 3 square will be 9. Now we will move further and we will find the Laplace transform of e raised to 2t sine cube t. So as we learned in the lecture of first shifting theorem, that is Laplace transform of e raised to at into f of t is equal to psi of s minus a, means you have to replace this s with s minus a, and a is nothing but your power of e. Okay, so here a is 2, so we will replace this s with s minus 2. So this will become, so first of all let's take this 3 common, so this will become 3 upon 4, and according to the first shifting theorem we will change this s with s minus a. Here a is 2, so s minus 2 square, s square will become s minus 2 square plus 1. Here it will become 1 upon s square, this s minus 2 square plus 9. So this completes your Laplace transform of f of t. Okay, and this is nothing but phi of s. Now we will apply the property, that is effect of division by t, that is we will multiply this function with 1 upon t. That is your example, given example. So 1 upon t into f of t sine q t. So according to the property, this is nothing but integration s to infinity into phi of s, means this whole answer. So let's write this 3 by 4 outside the integration sign. So you have to find integration of 1 upon s minus 2 square plus 1 minus 1 upon s minus 2 the whole square plus 9. And with respect to s, we will write ds. So we know the integration of 1 upon s square plus a square, that is, see here, tan square x. So this will become tan, so tan inverse x. So this will become tan inverse of here x, means here you have to take x as s minus 2 minus Now we also know the formula for integration of 1 upon x square plus a square. Okay. So here x is nothing but this bracket and a is nothing but 3 square, that is 9. So a is 3, x is this bracket and a is 3. So according to the formula, this will become 1 upon a, that is 1 upon 3 tan inverse of x upon a, so x is nothing but this bracket upon a, a is nothing but 3, and we will write the limits that s to infinity. Now before applying this limit, let's split this function and we will multiply this 3 by 4 inside the bracket. So this will become 3 by 4 tan inverse of s minus 2, and the limits will be s to infinity, minus 3 by 4 into, here it is 1 by 3 tan inverse of s minus 2 by 3, and the limits will be s to infinity. So in this step we have multiplied this 3 by 4 here also and here also, so we will get this step. Now let's apply the limit 3 by 4. Here upper limit minus lower limit. Upper limit says in place of s you have to take infinity, so tan inverse of infinity will become pi by 2. So this is upper limit. Minus lower limit, for lower limit you don't have to make any change because here it is also s and here it is also s, so this will become minus lower limit, so tan inverse of s minus 2. So this completes your first bracket. Here 3 and 3 get cancelled, you will get minus 1 by 4. Here also you have to apply limits, upper limit minus lower limit. So tan inverse of upper limit, that is infinity, tan inverse of infinity is pi by 2, minus lower limit, that is s, so you don't have to make any change. So tan inverse of s minus 2 by 3. Now the final step will be, we have the formula of trigonometry, that is pi by 2 minus tan inverse x is cot inverse x. So this will become 3 by 4 pi by 2 minus tan inverse x, that is cot inverse x. So this will become cot inverse s minus 2. Now minus 1 by 4. Here also pi by 2 minus tan inverse x. So this will become cot inverse x. So cot inverse, your x is s minus 2 by 3. So this is your final answer. So this completes our today's lecture, that is a numerical based on the property effect of division by t. Now we will continue this chapter, that is Laplace transform, in the next videos. Thank you very much for watching.